It's a pleasure to have Ms. Mona Ambegaonkar with us, outspoken, creative, and conscientious citizen. Mona, just about the last 1 week after Pulwama, what you've been through. Can you just tell us?
Mainly what has happened is that the Pulwama massacre is very close to my heart in the sense that I grew up in an Air Force family. I'm a 4G bacha. And so losing so many members of the uniform corps really hurts, okay? Also because they were not even in a combat situation. They were being transported from one location to the other location and in one of the most highly militarized zones in the world, yeah? And so I mourn for them, but I question why they died. That is my highest tribute to them, to find out why they died in a situation, in a condition where ideally, they should not even have been threatened. They should not have been in a situation where they are threatened. So I am questioning what went on. I am looking at news reports across the board on the internet, and I'm sharing those news reports where they are questioning how a 19-year-old boy could take 350 kgs, they said originally, and I don't know what the
truth is now. Now it's 250.
Well, 250 now, in kgs of explosives, and drive it into a convoy of 70 vehicles carrying 2,500 CRPF jawans. How did that happen? In Kashmir, if three police vehicles are driving together, you cannot overtake them. They will open the back door, put a gun at you and say, piche ho, and you have to stop and let them go big distance.
What exactly did you post on your...
So I have posted several things questioning this and questioning the government of the day, which is in power in Kashmir and at the center, where the HMO is also in command of the situation. It all belongs to the BJP, and I'm questioning them. And apparently, because I'm questioning them, I'm anti-national. So if I question the government of the day, a government we elected, right? And a government that represents even those who didn't elect them or who didn't vote for them, okay? If I question them about the security of the soldiers of my country, yeah, men who are dying for us and helping us during calamities, you know, in environmental calamities, etc. When I'm talking about why they died, so I'm supposed to be anti-national, and so now I've been targeted on one of these Facebook profiles where they are celebrating those who have been arrested for speaking against BJP or Modi, and I've been targeted on one of those profiles, and there is this very dedicated troll of mine called Hiten N. Bhatt, who has been going after me, and he keeps on tagging people to my posts. And one day I asked him, I said, why are you calling all the, who are all these people that you're inviting? And he said, they're all cynics. And I said, acha, cynics. So I said, okay, Tommy Shoe. Because as you see, I'm not a victim and I don't take it lying down. And I do know that canines hunt in packs. And I love canines and I rescue them and I look after them. I'm a huge animal rights activist. So if you look at my post and Arithro would know, I do a lot of rescue and rehabilitation work and everything. So I really know how canines work. And so I said, Tommy Shoe. And of course, they all call me communist bitch and everything. Huh? No, bitches don't, it really doesn't work for me. I like bitches. Yeah, I mean, I like female dogs, right? Communist, to pata nahi yaar, I work for and I espouse the rights of the workers, the farmers, the underprivileged, the disenfranchised people of this country. I speak for them. I do. I don't know if you like that or not, and if you call me communist.
Anyway, the last thing that this troll did was to actually threaten arrest.
Yeah.
So we'd like to ask that what kind of nexus is there between the guys who are trolling and the police who are acting? Are the police actually looking at what people are posting or are they just acting at political behest?
This profile actually celebrates how many people they managed to get arrested for speaking against the government, which is supposed to be the same as speaking against the country. I don't understand the parallel here. And he has tagged me saying ki is aurat ka profile zarur dekhna, iske sare post paise hain, ye Gujarati mein likha hua hai. I read Gujarati, okay? So now I'm just waiting for some kind of...
And then you said you posted your father's...
Yes, I did. On another post of mine, this guy went and kind of called his cynics, and one of the cynics came and said, you know, you're anti-national. And so I put up a post of a picture of my father who served with the Indian Air Force and who fought several wars, has the VMVSM. So I just said that as a comment. I did not counter him. I did not have an argument with him. Immediately he says to me, "No, no, hum apne sainikon ka wo karte hain, izzat karte hain." And so I said, "Nahi, tum jhoot bolte ho. Tum sainikon ki izzat nahi karte ho. तुम निहत्थों को जो भीड़ आक्रमण करती है ना जिन पे उनमें तुम पाए जाते हो, तुम उनमें से हो जो सिर्फ लोगों को उकसाते हैं, मेरे प्रोफाइल से दूर रहिए प्लीज़." तो उसके बाद उन्होंने कहा, "आप क्या कहने की कोशिश कर रही हैं?" तो मैंने कहा, "भाई पढ़ना नहीं आता, मैं कह रही हूँ मेरे प्रोफाइल से दूर रहो." तो उसके बाद वो बंदा तो एटलीस्ट शांत है, पर ये हितेन एन भट्ट जो है ये बहुत उकसाया। एक और चीज़, अभी कोबरा पोस्ट का स्टिंग हुआ ना अगेंस्ट दीज सेलिब्रिटीज इन द बॉलीवुड इंडस्ट्री अबाउट हाउ दे आर विलिंग टू टेक मनी एंड डू प्रोपेगेंडा फॉर द बीजेपी इन द कमिंग इलेक्शन। सो आई पुट दैट अप एंड आई सेड कि यू नो आर्टिस्ट आर सपोज टू बी द वॉइस of justice and reason, but these just seem to be cheap shits. This is my post. It's public, it's online, please go and look at it. I have not named any one of them. This is a sting carried out by Cobra Post, and that's it. So he has gone and said, usme ek mera dost bhi hai Akhilendra Mishra karke jo main jinke sath pehle kaam wagera bhi kar sakte ho, to usne kaha dekho Akhilendra Mishra ye tumhe badnaam kar rahi hai. To maine bhi Akhilendra Mishra ko tag kiya aur mole bola Akhilendra Mishra and did a laugh there. So wo tab se bichara shant ho gaya. Lekin the thing is that they will call you out, they hunt you, and if you get scared and if you retreat, then they will come after you like pack animals. That is how they hunt.
Basically, don't get scared.
Get scared, don't retreat. If you are saying the right thing, if you are in a place where your conscience is clear, when you are calling out corruption and greed and where souls are for sale, and you, so किसी ने इनफैक्ट इसी पोस्ट को बोला कि ये देखो ये बॉलीवुड तो सब रंडियों का समाज है. मैंने कहा ना ना ना, रंडी सिर्फ अपना शरीर बेचती है जो उसकी खुद की मिल्कियत है, वो अपना सोल नहीं बेचती, वो ईमान नहीं बेचती. तो प्लीज़ यार रंडियों का नहीं है, उनका अपमान ना करो. तो सो आई रियली बिलीव इन दिस, यू नो, एंड इट्स ऑल पब्लिक, इट्स आउट देयर. एंड सच में आई रियली रिस्पेक्ट सेक्स वर्कर्स बिकॉज यू नो इट मस्ट बी वेरी हार्ड बींग वेयर दे आर, एंड टू सेलिब्रेट दैट यू नो इज समथिंग दैट आई वुड डू, आई वुड ऑलवेज डू.
थैंक्स सो मच.